Hi, my name's Simone Labib. I play Alex Fielding in The Wire in the Blood. Welcome to ITV.com. Her name's Alex Fielding. She's a detective inspector, and she works alongside Tony Hill's character, who's a criminal profiler.
So you did have a relationship?
Professional, pastoral, teacher-pupil relationship.
You just said you never taught him.
I never taught him as such. I mean, I...
He said he intervened.
How did he intervene?
How did you intervene? Was it within the school?
Yes.
He's lying.
Where did you meet outside of the school?
You know, when you're doing episodic TV and you've played a character for a while, you know, you get to know them, you get to see them in so many different situations, and you learn how they react in these things. You know, you've had a long time to develop a character, and you get to know them quite well.
So how come you're running this on your own? Where's the new boy? He said something about checking out an informant. Well, he's not in the drug squad now. Tell him to get his ass up here and start pulling his weight.
Yeah, we have a new character that comes in, played by Christian Solomino, and basically he is, you know, a new police officer who is a kind of lawn to himself. He's a challenge to Alex because he's not reverent, but at the same time he's bright and has a lot to offer, so she recognizes that, you know, there's a lot there, and so, you know, she can't really dismiss him.
God almighty, what was your relationship?
I was I'm the boyfriend, or I was. She wanted it kept secret, and you know,
we have wasted hours since she disappeared. What the hell were you thinking?
I just lost it, I'm sorry.
Where were you at lunchtime?
Oh, come on, go.
I said, where were you at lunchtime?
I was in the canteen with Paula.
Don't shout at me.
It would appear that Tony is Alex's only friend, or at least the person that she's closest to, because she spends so much time at work. You know, because she grows to trust him, you know, the irony is that, you know, here he is, he's quite an eccentric character, and, you know, he kind of bumbles along with his plastic bags and, you know, is kind of clumsy in his own life, and yet, and doesn't have children, and yet, you know, can proffer these the great advice to her that, you know, often helps her in her situations, you know, almost like a surrogate partner sometimes, you know, where she doesn't have one, she can rely on his maleness, you know, to his point of view, you know, that kind of male point of view when it comes to rearing her son. So I think she relies on him a lot personally, as he does her.
Tony's neighbour thinks he's a bit mad.
Well, he is.
Ben.
Just a bit. In a good way.
Thank you, I think.
It's from all that looking into people's heads. Mum says you help her catch people because you can see inside their heads. Are you trying to catch someone right now?
Right now? We're having dinner.
You know, he's much more amusing as Robson Green than he is as Tony Hill, believe me. He's a very funny guy. I mean, there's quite, you know, he's funny, Michael's funny. You know, there's a lot of people with, very willing to laugh on set, you know, and that I think is a great release from the intensity of the work and the darkness of the work sometimes, I think. Yeah, no, and it makes it a fun place to work, you know. This is partly why, you know, I think the crew go back year after year and we go back as well. You know, it's a combination of feeling proud to be part of a good show and enjoying the work.